Hi, what's up you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to a brand new series on this channel. I'm celebrating 25 days of Christmas with Sarah on this channel. So there's going to be a brand new video every single day for 25 days of Christmas. I hope you guys are just as excited as I am for this series. I love Christmas. It's my favorite time of the year. There's going to be a lot of fun vlogs, a lot of playing with makeup and a lot of skincare videos. So I hope you guys enjoy all that I have in store for y'all. Today I'm playing with brand new makeup. Like a lot of new makeup that is new on the market, new to me. I have tried some of this in the past, so I already have established reviews for y'all, but some of this is also like first impression. It's a mix of both, and it's the look I'm wearing right now. It doesn't look very bad, but there have been ups and downs in this video, as you will see. So if you're interested, then keep on watching. But if you're new to my channel, please take a moment and hit the subscribe button and join the Sarah squad. If you're interested in honest beauty reviews, a lot of fun vlogs and relatable makeup content, I'm sure you'll have a great time here. And also click on the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. Okay, let's get started. I've already cleansed my face. I've used the Dermaweave Hydra Cleanser as always to prep my face before my makeup. And then I'm going to dive into moisturizer. As always, I'm just using my Nutriderm Vitamin E Moisturizing Lotion because I honestly can't seem to find a better moisturizer which will do well underneath makeup. And all the makeup that I'm trying today is fairly new, but I keep my skincare simple and old school. For primer, I'm starting with the Eclat Pro Makeup Primer. Now, this is something that has not been new to me. I have, of course, been trying it for very, very long and loving the finish of this. But I have not used it in any one of my videos. So most of the makeup that I'm using today, it's either not just new for me or on the market, it's also new because I've not introduced it on my channel properly, like not shown you all how it looks in action. So that is why I'm using it in today's video. This primer gives a very nice dewy base, and after I've applied it, it makes my makeup last really long. So I really like this one. Some of this is like first impressions, but most of it is proper reviews because I have been using this for some time now. Okay, you guys, I didn't have anything new for foundation, so I've just applied my Maybelline Fit Me foundation in the shade 330 Toffee. Y'all have already seen me use this and love this. So next, I'm going to dive into concealer, and for that, I'm using the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define in the shade C12. I've heard so many good things about this concealer. It has a really nice and big fat wand, and this is first impressions. I've never tried it. So let's see how well this shade does. I found this shade for myself on foundation, and I think it's pretty good. It has a neutral undertone. It's not too cool toned or warm toned. Deep actually loves this concealer. I'm just gonna apply it underneath my eyes. I'm going for heavy concealing because I haven't been sleeping well lately. So mama needs it, honey. I'm just gonna conceal the usual areas. First impressions, I really do like how the feel of it is. Like, it's very gliding on very easily. Let's see how well it blends. So taking my sponge, and I'm gonna dab. For me, a good concealer is something that can, one, cover up my hyperpigmentation, and also it should not be creasing a lot. So I don't have a lot of under eye creases, but I do have some fine lines. Okay, I'm turning old, although not that old, but I do have fine lines, and I don't want it to emphasize that. So let's see how well it blends. It's blending very easily. It's not giving me a hard time to blend. So kudos for that. But I feel like it is sinking into my fine lines. Let's see. Let's set it and then we'll decide. This color of concealer, I don't know how I feel about it. Isn't it a little too cool toned? I would have to mix a little bit of a warmer concealer with this. Okay, so first impressions, I think this shade C12 is a little too cool toned for me. I don't like the undertone that much. I think a warmer concealer will have to be mixed with this. So if you're looking for, if like your cooler undertone, it's perfect. But if your warmer undertone and anything close to my shade in skin tone, I think you should look for a warmer undertone in this. They have a lot of shades to offer, so that's why it was a little confusing and overwhelming. It's also great to have that much diversity, but it's a little overwhelming. So I found my shade on foundation.com. And I mean, it's not the worst thing in the world, but it's giving me a sort of a white cast, you know, like, and I don't know, I really don't like how it's looking underneath my eyes. Like, it looks, it's a little too drying if I will. Like, it makes me look cakey underneath the eyes. Can you see? Like, it's emphasizing my fine lines and making me look 10 times more my age, sort of. Like, I feel that way. Alright, after setting my face, also I'm not really liking how this concealer sits on my skin. It's sitting, like literally sitting. It's not like blended very well, creasing a bit, making me look very old and also giving me a very cool undertone. So shade wise as well as formula wise, it's not the best. It's priced at about $650, so it's very close to my LA Girl concealer, but in formula it doesn't match up. So I would still vote for my LA Girl concealer over this. I'm not saying I hate it, but I don't like it as much. Like 5/10. Next, for bronzer, I have this Wet n Wild Color Icon Bronzer in the shade Watch Shady Beaches, and this is honestly the product I'm most excited for. It's a big pan of bronzer, okay, and it's so difficult to find good bronzers on the Indian market, and Wet n Wild is a good company, but at the same time it's also an affordable company. The affordable bronzer, if it's good in performance, honestly is going to be my favorite one. It in the pan, it's so beautiful, right? Like this golden bronzy shade that will give me that Brazilian glow. So I have high expectations. I'm just going to place this here. Ooh, I like the shade. The shade is really good. It's a nice warm toned color. Good pigmentation also. It's not too much. It can be built, like, first swipe, it's not too much that it's overwhelming, and then you can build it up. This concealer is already creasing in this area, like so badly creasing in this area, and I hate how my under eyes look. So I think the 5/10 is going to go lower to maybe a 2 or a 3 now. And I really like this bronzer, definitely an 8/10. It has a very nice bronzy glow. It has some like very sheeny shimmer flecks in it, so it's giving that glow while not emphasizing any texture. Like, I have some like one pimple over here, but it's not emphasizing it, and I really really like how it looks on my skin tone. So 8/10, aram se 8/10 for this. For blush, I have another product that I've absolutely been loving, and this is the Milani Wild Rose Powder Blush in the shade 13. This blush looks stunning in the like package, but at the same time, it's such a long wearing blush. So off camera, I have been literally wearing it every single day now because I'm obsessed with the color payoff. It's so beautifully pigmented. At the same time, it's not too much. You can aram se build it up, and it's very long wearing. Matlab, I do 14-hour, 12-hour shoots nowadays, and it's staying put throughout that, and it's commendable how well it looks on camera as well as off camera too. And I love a good blush, so highly recommend. Of course, it is a little expensive for a blush. It's like 1050, but if you're looking for a good one that you just want and you're good to go, you should definitely try this one. For highlighter, I'm using this duo by Estee Lauder. This is their Pure Color Envy Sculpting Duo Blush and Highlight. So I'm using the highlight shade in this palette. It's in the shade Coral Fever. So it has a coral blush as well as this highlighter. It had a brush over here that I'm not using because I don't use those brushes, and it fell off. It's a really pretty highlight. I've not used it that much, but look at the glow. It's very subtle, like it's not in your face. Very very subtle champagne rose gold pearlescent effect. So I've not used it on camera that much, which is why I'm using it today, but off camera I've been really loving this glow that it gives me. Okay, so to set this face in place, I'm using the Milani Make It Last setting spray. Now this bottle, I have heard such good reviews about from international YouTubers, and I've been wanting to try it for very long, but for this small bottle, it costs about $1,000, and I found it very expensive, because like, if I'm paying $1,000 for what, 60 ml, how much? Fix Plus is more product, right? MAC Fix Plus, and it's 1500 rupees. So I would rather buy MAC Fix Plus than this, but I've not tried it till now. So let's wear it now, give you all the first impressions, and see how long this makeup lasts. And I will leave it in the comments maybe about how well it made my makeup last, because already my under eyes are creasing. Ooh, I like the fragrance on this. Very nice fragrance. And also the nozzle is good, distributes product evenly. Just gonna pick up any excess product if I have any on my face right now. That's it for face makeup. I think my face is looking good apart from my concealer. Till now we have two for sure winners and as a bronzer, and even the setting spray is good for now. Okay, so the face makeup is all done. I'm going to zoom you guys in and let's dive into new eye makeup. For my brows, I'm using the Fay Beauty brush in the shade dark brown. I've really been enjoying how this looks on the brows, honestly, because it's super easy to use if you have like already pre-filled brows the way I do. It's a great brow filler cum gel, gives you a very natural sort of a fill, and dark brown is very subtle, so it gives a nice natural look, fills all your sparse gaps and also sets your brow hairs in place. So it does like a very good job actually at multitasking. I'm not enjoying it that much on the lashes when I want like a very full look, but when I want like a subtle look, then it works really well on the lashes too. So for eyeshadow, I have something brand new. This is the Wet n Wild Stop Playing Safe eyeshadow palette, the bigger ones. I've tried Wet n Wild shadows in the past and I do really like their pigmentation. For the price of it, it's really good, but I've never tried the bigger ones and I really like the color combination. I actually got this in a package with my order in HOK Makeup. So HOK Makeup has a lot of like these bundles. So usme I had ordered, but I've mentioned all about it in my haul video. So if you've not checked the haul out, I'm gonna link it here for you guys. So I'm just gonna put this in my crease first. I'm starting with this transition color right here, and I'm actually gonna use it as a transition shade. Just gonna set this concealer that's literally creasing every freaking wear and annoying the shit out of me. But ooh, I like the pigmentation of Wet n Wild shadows. They are a little too powdery, but you know, for the price of it, I'm not gonna complain. The color combination on this palette is strangely playful. Like, I mean, I can go very subtle with all these nudes and pink and maybe the shimmer, which is what I'm gonna do, but you can also play it like really risky and go for these blues and greens. So if you're someone who wants to experiment with your makeup game, I think this is perfect. Taking this dark brown shade on a denser crease brush, gonna place it on my outer corner. Just blending it on the outer corner over here. Blends so beautifully. I mean, look, there's no patchiness, nothing at all. Wet n Wild shadows are good, you guys. And also look at the pigment, matlab. Not at all dusty, huh? It's a little powdery, but that's okay. Like, there's slight fallout, but I don't mind fallout. On the same brush, I'm taking a little bit of this dusty pink shade and I'm gonna pack it next to the dark brown, like not all over the lid, just uske thoda baju mein to add a little bit of a pink touch. It doesn't have the best color payoff. Let's build it up and see. Decent. Not the worst, not the best. Okay, finally for the inner corner, I'm going to take this shimmery sort of a pearlescent glitter that is a little too powdery, and I think I'm going to get a lot of fallout out of it. But let's see how it looks on the eyes. It is very powdery, you guys. It's too powdery. Nah, this color is not doing it. It's not doing it. Shit, I don't have any other color. It's very bad. The color is really bad. Let's just swatch some. You know what? I'm just gonna take this highlighter from the Estee Lauder palette and I'm gonna put that. Ooh, just this is what a shimmer should look like. Smooth and blend like butter. Like, shimmers are the easiest shadows to make, Wet n Wild. I'm surprised that your mattes are better than your shimmers. I'm going to swatch the other shimmers on my hand and see how they perform. Okay, you know what? I'm going to swatch these other shimmers and see how well they perform. Ooh, this blue is nice. It's nice. This is also looking really, really good. Oh, dude. I think only this shade was shitty. This lemon yellow. Okay. I think they messed up with the lighter colors. These two colors are not doing it for me. Like, look, this is so flaky, it barely shows up, and it's also patchy, like it's not buttery enough, it's all flaking away. But I think the other colors are good to go, and the mattes to blend it really, really well. So I would give this palette an 8/10, I think, just for two shades being bad at that price. It's not really a complaint. I'm gonna go ahead and do my lower lash line. First I'll take the same transition color and then I'll go in with a darker brown and a little bit of the pink. We'll be right back. For eyeliner, I'm using the Estee Lauder Little Black Liner in the shade Onyx. I'm going to take like the ultra fine side and draw a nice winged eyeliner. This eyeliner is really good. It's pigmented. It has two sides to it. This is the thin side and there's also like a thicker side. It is like bulkier, like it has this ultra like a marker feel, but I don't like that side that much. But the thin felt tip side is really really good to draw a wing because the felt tip is very firm and nice, and the pigmentation on the eyeliner is good. For kohl, I'm using the Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place Eye Pencil in the shade Onyx again. So it's a nice black kohl. Again, been using this one a lot off camera because it's like those old school kajals, you know, in the pencil. And I really like pencil kajals better than the non-pencil ones, whatever they're called, you know, the ones which roll on top. This is really pigmented and it doesn't burn my eyes. A lot of kajals irritate my eye, but this one doesn't. For brow bone highlight and everything, I'm just going to take the same Estee Lauder highlighter and I'm going to put it in my inner corner as well as my brow bone because that palette doesn't really have a good highlighting shade. The lightest color is so flaky, so it won't do the job. Okay, for mascara, I'm using this one right here. This is by PAC. This is the Big Lashes Mascara and I am in love with this. I've been using it literally every single day. You all know for the longest time, I was only obsessed with my Estee Lauder and my L'Oreal one, and I think the Estee Lauder is about to be replaced. You guys are going to be replaced by this one. The formula is so good and I love this thick wand. It has two wands. It has one for the lower lashes as well, which is perfect. But you can use this thick wand both places actually. But the formula, oh my god, the formula. Lengthening, volumizing, and somewhere around 500, so which is a good price for a mascara. So the thinner wand on this is like this thin, like can you see, it's like pencil thin and it's really precise and the formula is the same, and but it applies and clings to your lashes really well. So I do actually like it. Usually I don't like double ended mascaras because it's way too much work, but I really like how this one makes my lower lashes look, so I'm up for the extra step. Alright, for lips, I have a brand new lip pencil. It's been a while since I've bought a new lip liner and this is the Milani Color Statement Lip Liner in the shade 09. I think it's Spice and I love this nude color. I've been using it a lot off camera. It's a very different nude shade than what I usually use. So this is what it looks like. It's very very muted, very very toned down nude shade. Usually these sort of colors tend to wash me out, so I refrain from them, but like this lip liner, the formula is very long wearing, as well as this shade would look really good with those nude colors that wash you out and you don't want to change the color of the lipstick too much, you know, otherwise you use a very dark lip liner and then it like really changes the color of the lipstick. That won't happen with such a shade, so I really really like this color. For lipstick, I'm going to use the Estee Lauder Pure Color Envy in the shade 420. I have the mini right here. I have two of their lipsticks, but this is the one I'm going to use today. It's fresh, like really really new, so I'm going to use it and see what the color looks like. So it looks like a nice pinky nude shade in the tube. Really pink, very very pink actually. Alright you guys, so this is the look all complete using fairly new makeup, which is not just new on the market but also new to me. I think my complete winners from today's video, which I would absolutely recommend that you go get your hands on now, has to be the Wet n Wild Color Icon Bronzer. Really loved this one and have been loving the Milani blush. Highly highly recommend. Also the Milani lip liner, really good shade, really good formula. The PAC Lashes Big Lashes Mascara, again another one of my favorites, and also the Fave Beauty Brash in dark brown for your brows, another one of my favorites. So like these I highly highly recommend. Apart from these products, also whatever I tried like did not suck like horribly because like my makeup looks really good. I don't like the Estee Lauder Pure Color Envy formula that much because it's a little bit of a glossy matte formula. It's not completely matte. And I like my lipsticks really really matte, so I'm not very comfortable with this. The eyeshadow palette was decent, 7 to 8 on 10. concealer was a complete letdown. Like, I mean, I just can't with that concealer. It looks horrible and I'm not gonna be using it. I'll try like mixing it with a couple other concealers and see if it works, but I do not recommend, especially like I'm oily skin, but somehow it just makes my under eyes dry, clings really badly, does not look good. So definitely not worth the hype, because I've heard so much about that concealer and it did not live up. So I'm disappointed in that concealer big time. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, and also let me know in the comment section what other videos you'll want to see for 25 days of Christmas. For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Rajshri Dangi. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, all you gotta do is hit the subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video tomorrow itself, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you're notified when it goes up tomorrow. I love you guys so much. Bye, take care.